Let us pray. Holy God, in the pages of Scripture, we read of your call to Philip and Nathanael. Open our minds and hearts to also hear your call to us. You are the one who continues to call us and invite us to take part in your divine purpose to redeem all humankind. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Tom began for us last week the Gospel of John, where we will be through the end of May, working through the Gospel of John. So today we are still in the first chapter, picking up with verse 43. The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I have told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Come and follow me. Isn't it amazing that we are even called to come and follow? Each of us in all our differences are called. God calls not only individuals whom the church then ordains, as we will do later today, but God calls each of us. When we look at the scripture carefully, we find a God who meets people where they are, and a God that invites people to be in relationship with him, no matter where they are, what their circumstances are, or what they have or have not done. The challenge for us is to slow down, to see how God is working in our lives, and then to share that with others. For each one of us, the story may be just a little different, but one thing that is the same is that God does call each of us. That invitation is for us to come and follow. We don't have to be a Bible scholar or perfect, thank goodness, to accept God's invitation. So we're not given much detail from John as to how Philip came to follow, just that Jesus found him and said, "Follow me." But when Philip finds Nathanael and wants to share the news about Jesus, we do get a glimpse of what is important to Philip. He said to Nathanael, "We have found him about whom Moses and the law and the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." So it seems to be important to Philip that Jesus fulfills the scripture written by Moses and the prophets. So even though we don't know what Jesus may have said to Philip, he must have convinced him that he was the one scripture was talking about. Now Philip, in all of his excitement, wants others to come to know Jesus, to know that he is the one. And so full of excitement, as people often are when they first come to know the love and grace of God, the peace that passes understanding, he goes to Nathanael and invites Nathanael to come. But Nathanael gives a response that I think we fear most when we share with others. He doubts Philip. And he challenges him. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? And what does Philip say? He doesn't preach. He doesn't argue. He doesn't quote scripture, even though he knows scripture, and scripture is very important to him. He just says, come and see. Come, check it out for yourself. Don't take my word for it if you don't want to. I love it. Philip is not threatened by Nathanael's questions or doubts. He doesn't beat him over the head with scripture. He doesn't try to instill fear. You better believe, or else do you know where you're going if you die tonight? No, he is so sure that Jesus is who Jesus says he is that all he has to do is invite Nathanael to come and see. Jesus, through the Holy Spirit, will do the rest. So Nathanael accepts the invitation. But when he sees Jesus, he still has doubts and challenges Jesus. How do you know me? Jesus' answer gives Nathanael reason to believe in him himself. And we find in his answer what is important to Nathanael. Nathanael calls Jesus Rabbi, meaning teacher, Son of God, King of Israel. Maybe there was more to the conversation, maybe not, we don't know, but Nathanael came looking for a reason to believe or to not believe. Jesus was able to meet both Philip and Nathanael where they were. He invited them to come and follow, and they did. Did you notice that Jesus doesn't rebuke Nathanael for questioning? Just meets him where he is and says, you haven't seen anything yet. Just wait and see. You're only beginning to understand who I am. There is so much more, but one step at a time. Come and follow. We often don't perceive God's call and God's movement in our own lives. But just as God gave Nathanael Philip to invite and lead him to Jesus, God often gives us others that he will speak through. God gives us each other to encourage one another and to support one another. And then we can invite others to come and see. Come and follow. Be still and listen. So we are all called to follow, and we are all called to lead. My heart is broken when leaders in the church get burned out and lose their joy of following Christ. And so I charge those of us in leadership, whether music leadership, Sunday school leadership, administrative leadership, Presbyterian women leadership, session leadership, sound leadership, preschool leadership, whatever role it is that God has called you to, do not forget your first love. Follow Jesus daily. Walk with Jesus daily. Get your to-do list from him. Delegate. Invite others to follow and to serve. And I charge all of us to pray for one another. Support one another. Help one another. Give grace abundantly to one another. To do unto others as you would have them do to you. As we start this new year, remember we gather on Sunday mornings to worship, to fellowship, to reconnect, and then to go out into this world. I encourage you to let the elders and let Katie and let Kelly come and worship. They're not working on Sunday morning. Give them some grace and don't bombard them on Sunday morning. I know sometimes that's the only time we see each other, but if you just need to tell them that there's a light bulb out or could you put something in the bulletin, just leave a note in their box on Sunday morning. Let them worship and greet them as your brothers and sisters in Christ. Today we ordain and install those whom God has called to be a part of our session, to lead this congregation. They are called to be godly leaders and examples for us all. Some of us are called to specialized ministries within the church, and all of us should pray for those leaders God has called. Indeed, part of the service is for you, the congregation, to promise to support, to pray for, to follow those God has called to lead. But remember, all of us, each and every one, is called. Maybe not into ordained ministry, but we are called to follow, and we are called to lead. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.